Good day. I'm Mary Grace Amores from EDUC 2B presenting you the Chapter 17 about trends and issues in teaching learners with difficulty with self-care. Okay, we start na. Many studies have found that the learners with or without disabilities were proved to have higher achievement in improved skills through inclusive educations. So, yung mga with or without disabilities, kapag sinama daw sila or in-inclusion sila sa general educations, they prove na nagkakaroon ng higher achievements and improvement skills yung mga learners na yon. In addition, having separate environments provide a context exclusion of those fail to reach the average of learning and behavioral characteristics expected of them. And then, exclusion makes the learners with those disabilities have even teaches to frame the capabilities of learners with disabilities, which produce low self-determination and self-esteem among learners with disabilities. In this chapter, we studies about inclusion among learners with difficulties and will be discussed to help present the picture of the effects of inclusion among different learners. So, we will study the inclusion of the learners with disabilities. Malalaman natin dito sa chapter 17 kung ano nga ba yung effect nito sa mga learners na may disability saka sa mga learners na walang disabilities. Yung inclusion, yung pagsasama-sama nila. Ano yung magandang effect nito sa kanila. So, by the ILO or Intended Learning Outcomes, ano nga ba yung meaning nito? So, dito sa ILO, they have a question here. What do I want about my students? So, ano nga ba yung gusto kong malaman tungkol sa kanila, sa mga estudyante ko? How can I facilitate that learning? Ano nga ba yung paano ko ba sila pwedeng mag-guide in teaching and learning activities? Tapos, what do I want to my students to learn? Ano nga ba yung gusto ko na matutunan ng mga estudyante ko? And how do I know that learning does happen? At paano ko malalaman na yung learning na to ay mangyayari sa kanila? And in the assessment of tests. So, dito sinasabi dito na yung intended learning outcomes ay yung learner-centered. Okay? And simply discuss the intended learning outcomes, statements describing what students know, understand, and can do with their knowledge, as well as what they feel and believe as a result of their learning experience. Kung ano yung nalalaman nila, ano yung naiintindihan nila, ano yung nararamdaman nila, or ano yung mga pinapaniwalaan nila. Ito yun, intended learning outcomes. So, let's move on sa inclusion. So, engage to the inclusion. To implement the inclusion is to first to understand the meaning of inclusion. Ano nga ba to? The most relevant education conceptualization at this point in this time is based on a UNESCO report, 2016 daw, that states that inclusive education is the sole process. So, ito yung katangi-tanging proseso ensuring that all learners share the same educational opportunities, di ba? We need to share the same educational opportunities sa lahat ng learners. And as their same age peers, okay? Literature would show that inclusion is providing all educational services to students with disabilities. So, we need to provide ng educational service same sa disabilities doon, katulad ng binibigay natin sa mga without disabilities in a general education setting. O, diba? Sinabi na nga doon sa IDOL 1997. In similarity, inclusion is about full membership of an age-appropriate class in the local school doing the same lessons as other people. Hall in Florian 2005. And then, the UNESCO has made clear its stand on what educational system needs to provide and according to the organizations. And this one, education, ano nga ba yung meaning nito? Education is not simply about making schools available for those who are already able to access them. Okay? Hindi lang ginawa yung school sa mga available kung sino lang yung pwede maka-access. But it is about being proactive and identifying the barriers or obstacles learners encountered in attempting to access opportunities for quality educations. So this is being proactive para ma-identify natin yung mga hadlang or barriers, yung mga obstacles na na-encountered ng mga learners na kung sino man yung gusto makapag-access doon sa opportunities ng quality educations. As well as, it removing those barriers, yung pagtanggal ng mga barriers na to, and obstacles that leads to exclusions. Okay. UNESCO 2016. These barriers may be classified as attitudinal and environmental barriers. So, meron palang dalawang barriers. These are the attitudinal and environmental barriers. According to the 2011 World Report on Disabilities, World Health Organization 2011, environmental barriers, ito yung meaning niya, include inaccessible policies. Yung environmental barriers daw siya. Ito daw yung mga hindi ma-access na policies, hindi ma-access na informations, at yung mga hindi ma-access na service delivery provisions. While dun sa attitudinal barriers, these are the meaning, it includes dito yung mga negative attitudes, yung mga maling pag-uugali, negative imagery, mga maling imahe, and language, stereotypes, stigma, and discriminations. Therefore, sinasabi dito na yung inclusion is a process that helps to overcome barriers. Ito daw yung proseso para malampasan natin yung mga barriers. Yung inclusion daw, siya daw yung parang pinaka key to overcome the barriers. Limiting the presence, participations, achievements of the learners. Doon, at sinasabi to sa UNESCO 2017, page 13. And sinasabi pa dito, let's move on. There's not a single agreed definition of inclusion. Wala daw silang single agreed definition ng inclusion. At based on Howard Albert Morgan and Conrad 2017, there was no clear consensus that exists in the field about the meaning of inclusion. And with about the definition, pero ang sinasabi na definitions na inclusion, inclusion would mean full-time placement. Ito yung full-time placement of students with disabilities, di ba? From the word full-time placement of students with disabilities in regular classroom. So, ito na inclusion na ng mga with disabilities sa regular classroom. But there may be referred inclusion as any degree of integration of learners with disabilities into the mainstream classroom. Okay. Ultimately, the way inclusion is defined affects the way it is interpreted and implemented. So, inclusion daw ay nagde-define siya kung ano yung nakaka-affect, kung paano yung pamamaraan or interpreted at paano yung implemented yung pagsasagawa nito. And with any interpretations, it is essential to see the effects of inclusion on both regular learners with disabilities. So, ano nga ba yung mga effects nito effects ng inclusion sa mga regular learners, yung mga walang disabilities or walang makapansanan, at ano rin ba yung mga effect nito sa mga learners with disabilities? Okay, and then finding from the larger number research, studies show positive effects of inclusion as listed below. Ito na siya. Dun sa mga with disabilities, ito yung mga positive effects nila. Doon sa higher, nagkakaroon sila ng higher expectation for student learning. Mas tumataas yung expectation nila sa mga natututunan ng mga students nila. Heightened engagement, so mas nakapag-engage. Effective demeanor. And participation in integrated social activities. So, mas nakakapag-participate sila sa mga social activities nila. Ayon pa kay Han, Parham, Davis, Beck, Steve, Curtis, and Goetz, 1994. And improve communications and social skills. Ayon naman pa kila Bill Kelman, Miranda, 2005, Fisher, yun siya. And so on. And also, more satisfying and diverse social relationship. So, mas nasasatisfy sila. At mas nadadiverse pa, mas napapadami pa yung kaalaman nila at social relationship nila, di ba? At nagkakaroon ng better academic outcomes in the areas of literacy and mathematics. O, di ba? Mas gumagaling pa sila sa mga areas of literacy nila at sa mga mathematics areas nila. At nagkakaroon sila ng lesser absences from school and referrals for disruptive behavior. Yun yung mga magagandang effects, di ba? At ay naman dito kay Brinker, achievements of more IEP. At nagkakaroon pa sila ng mga achievements more IEP goals, o di ba? At higit sa lahat, na-enhance pa ng mga adult outcomes in the areas of post, secondary education, employment, and independence. So, napakadami talaga ng positive effects nitong with disabilities. Itong inclusion doon sa with this inclusion ng mga disabilities sa walang kapansanan. So, inclusion is not just seems as advantage to the people with disabilities, but also to those without disabilities. This may be reflected in the findings of the following research articles. At yung, hindi lang daw siya sa mga may mga positive effects sa with disabilities, may magandang epekto din siya sa walang disabilities. Ito siya. Number one, develop friendship. Nade-develop nila yung pagkikipagkaibigan nila. Leadership skills, yung pagiging leaders. And social competence, yung social, yung pakisalamuha, yung competency sa pakisalamuha. Number two, reduce fear of human. Yung nababawasan nila yung takot nila sa tao. Yung pagkakaiba, differences accompanied. Yung pagkakaiba nila sa mga nakakasama nila by increasing comfort and awareness. At mas na-increase pa nila yung comfort at pagiging aware nila sa mga tao na may disabilities. Positive growth in social cognition. O, diba? Mas tumataas pa yung kaalaman nila sa social cognition. And then, increased academic achievement. Mas tumataas yung mga achievements nila sa akademiko. Assignment completion and classroom participation. Yan talaga yung magandang mga effect nito sa mga without disabilities pag sila yung napasama dun sa mga with disabilities. Improve attitude. Mas na-improve pa yung attitudes nila towards diversity. Towards sa iba't ibang klase ng tao. Ayan. And also, unique opportunities for learning, prejudice, and equity. Ito yung pagkakaantay-pantay at mga pagbibigay ng mga opportunities sa mga learners. Ayun siya. So, the rationale for the inclusion is also supported by the fact that no studies conducted since the late 1970s have shown an academic advantage for students with disabilities educated in separated setting. Ito yung sinasabi ni Falbe 2004. In fact, studies have shown some negative effects of separate special education placement. Ito naman yung sinasabi nila, custom. And also, this therefore includes that there are far more benefits of inclusion than giving separate settings for learners with disabilities. So, nagkakaroon pa siya ng more benefits dun sa inclusion kaysa doon sa pag-separate ng mga disabilities sa mga regular learners. So, much better pa rin siguro talaga yung nakakasama ng mga regular students, yung mga with disabilities, di ba? Mas marami siyang positive outcomes. Marami silang positive na natututunan. At yung, kumbaga, equality na pagtingin nila sa tao at respect towards dun sa mga classmates nila. Okay. What are those difficulties? In the Philippines, the practice of inclusion is being implemented by general education. So, sa Pilipinas daw, yung practice ng educations daw ay yung practice ng inclusion daw, sorry. Yung, sa Pilipinas, yung practice ng inclusion was implemented na siya sa general education teachers. Pero may mga true difficulties. What are those? Malalaman natin yan. However, studies reveal that these teachers seems to have difficulties in this implementation. Ito na yung sinasabi natin na may mga difficulties na sa implementation na yun. Based on Wega in Echabia 2011, report that general education teachers are not prepared to handle students with disabilities. Ayan na, yung mga general education teachers daw, hindi daw sila prepared na mag-handle ng mga students na yan with disabilities, with their classes. Paano na? Due to the fact that there was no mandatory course, ayun po. Kasi po, diba, due to the fact nga na wala daw kasi mandatory course na nagde-training or training on both there in their service, in pre-service teacher, educational institution. Yun po, so sad. On another study, sa iba namang pag-aaral, then in the pre-service level, dun sa Bostos, ayun kay Bostos, 2012, may mga iba naman itong pag-aaral noon. Revealed that having one course on special education, ayun na, meron ng mga special education course, di ba? Helps the pre-service teacher para matutunan ng mga teachers yung pre-service. Improve their attitudes para matutunan nila yung mga attitudes nila towards inclusion. But this course, nonetheless, was not effective in equipping them with strategies in handling inclusion. Pero hindi rin daw siya nagiging epektibo dahil sa equipment ng mga strategies in handling inclusions in the regular classroom. The findings of the studies about yung mga nalalaman nila dito corroborates with the study of Custodian 2019, stating that in service teacher or the cooperating teachers were found to be unsuccessful. Minsan daw talaga hindi nagiging unsuccessful yung mga teachers in preparing sa pre-service teachers or students teachers toward inclusive educations. Paano na? Due to lack of teacher preparations. The study also observed that there were no practice. Kasi nga, kulang nga sila, diba, sa practice. On differentiate instructions, modifications, and accommodations among due regular teachers of the school participation. Due to these findings, it was recommended that both pre-service and in-service teachers should have training. And this was recommended na parehas na yung pre-teachers at in-service teachers should have training in handling inclusive educations. Most especially that a new policy was born. Yan, mas maganda nga yan. na nagkaroon na ng implemented na ganun para naman matutunan ng mga pre-teachers na mahawakan nila yung mga disabilities students nila. The latest educational reform in the country have focused on the inclusion of students with disabilities in the general education setting. The policy guidelines on the K-12 basic education program or the DO21 section 2019, for instance, integrates inclusive education in the K-12 curriculum, making inclusive education its more principal taught. This policy, an inclusive education framework, was adopted to provide access and participation to diverse learners. To actualize inclusion, para malaman natin ang actual na inclusion nito, the policy suggests strengthening contextualization. Okay, di ba? Yung mga policies na to, nagsuggest sila na mas mapatibay nila yung contextualization of the curriculum and learning materials. Makapag-provide pa sila ng mga learning materials, making sure that there are differentiated presentation of informations at makapagbigay ng iba't ibang presentasyon ng information sa bawat students with or without disabilities. Content the learning materials, yung pagbibigay ng mga content ng learning materials to support understanding para mas madali itong maunawaan ng mga learners. Some of these ways is by ensuring access to all learners. Sa mga pamamaraan na ito, para ma-ensure nila that all learners will be access of the educations, such as using videos, eto na. Katulad ng pagbibigay ng mga videos with having amplified sounds and subtitles having assigned language, interpreter in the class, pagbibigay na ng mga interpreter in the class, providing graphic symbols, yan yung mga braille, di ba? Yung mga sa mga bulag, nakapagbigay na ng mga examples ng graphic symbols nito para kahit pa paano makasabay sila sa mga regular students nila. And then, minsan di ba sa rooms, kung napapansin nyo, may mga TV na din, di ba? Para mas napapanood nila yung mga, usually nakikita ko sa mga kinder, may mga educational naman, ginagamit nila yung TVs for educational. Ayun. Para mas makasabay sila. And also, graphic symbols with alternative text descriptions. Ito nga yung mga braille. Using simpler words and having materials enlarged to transcribe into braille. Yan. These learning resources shall be utilized to engage active participations and interaction of all learners. But how diverse are our learners? Ito na nga. Ito daw yung nakakapag-engage para makapag-participate at makapag-interaction o makisalamuha yung mga learners nila. Pero, paano makapag-diverse yung mga learners nila? Ito na siya. To help us answer these questions, para malaman natin, presented below is the diversity wheel developed by Loden and Rosner in 1990. This is a frame with concentric circles that show different dimensions of diversity within individuals and institutions. So, ito na yung tinatawag nilang diversity wheel. So, etong diversity wheel na to, dito napapaloob yung personality, and internal, external, and organizational, and then the era. So, dito sa personality, ito yung mga personalidad natin. And dito sa internal, napapaloob dito yung age, race, sexual orientation, gender. So, yung mga basic information naman to. Decisions, mental stability, ethnicity, and national origin. And goes on to the internal, we have the socioeconomic status, education, interests, citizenship, appearance, belief system, religion, relationship status, family status, experience, and geographic locations. Ayan po. Sa organizationals naman, function, union affiliation, work content field, and seniority or tenure, department or division, work location, manage status or title. And then dito naman sa era, historical events, the cultural events, the political events, and then the world events. So these are the five layers of diversity wheels. Shows the complexity of the diversity filters through which people process stimuli. Kung paano nakapag-diversity yung bawat personality, bawat tao, at paano sila nakapag-process ng stimuli nila and informations. This shows that the people assumption drive their behaviors. Kung paano niya nadadrive yung pag-ugali niya that impact to other people. In the classroom, learner diversity may include learners' abilities. Yung knowledge, na-include din dito yung knowledge, yung learning styles nila, study habits, interests, motivation, multiple, intelligence, and belief systems. With these varied characteristics, teachers' plan and action in the classroom impose huge impacts to students' learning. It is therefore imperative that varied ways are implemented to support diverse learning characteristics. Ayan po. So, the Universal Design for Learning, or tinatawag na UDL, as discussed in Chapter 13, so presents the lines in providing multiple means of engagement and representations and actions, expressions below presents and UDL guidelines by the Center for Applied Special Technology class. Okay? So, ito na Universal Design Learning Guidelines kung paano natin, ito yung mga guides, paano natin matuturo to sa mga learning natin. Provide multiple means of engagement. Ano nga ba to? Affective network and the way of learning. And the next is provide option for recruiting interest. Ito naman yung mga provide option of recruiting interest. These are the optimize individual choice and autonomy, optimize relevance value and authenticity, minimize threats and distractions. Okay, diba? Ito naman tayo sa provide options for sustaining efforts and persistence. Okay, yung persistence, yung tuloy-tuloy. Heighten silence of goals and objectives. Vary demands and resources to optimize challenge. Foster collaborations and community. Increase mastery-oriented feedback. Okay, diba? Dito naman tayo sa provide multiple means of representation. Recognition network, the what of learning. Yung kanina sinabi natin, ito yung why of learning. E dito naman tayo sa what of learning. Dito sa what of learning, provides assumption for perception. Ano nga ba yung provide assumption for perception? Offer ways customizing displays of informations. Nagbibigay tayo ng mga ways of customizing. So, yung mga ginagawa ng mga display informations. Offer alternative for auditory informations. So, yung mga bulag, nakakapagbigay tayo ng alternative in auditory information. Offer alternates or visual informations. Diba? Provide options of language and symbols. Clarify vocabulary and symbols. Verify syntax and structure. Support decoding of text, mathematical notations, and symbols. Promote understanding across language. Illustrate through multiple media. And then, dito naman tayo sa how. Provide multiple means of action and expression. Ito yung how. Diba? How of learning. The how of learning. Provide options of physical action. Vary the methods of response and navigations. Optimize access to tool and assistive technologies. Provide options for expression and communications. Dito tayo. Ano ba yung meaning ng expressions and communications? Use multiple media. Mas nakakapagbigay tayo ng multiple media for communications. Use multiple tools for constructions and compositions. And build fluencies with graduated levels of support for practice and performance. Diba? Ang daming mga activities dito. Dito sa how, nasa likod kasi siya. Internalize, provide options for self-regulations. Dito sa self-regulation, promote expectation and beliefs that optimize motivation. Facilitate personal coping skills and strategies. Develop self-assessment and reflection. And also, provide options for comprehension. Dito tayo sa, diba kanina sa why? And sa what naman tayo? Sa what? Provide option for comprehension. Activate or supply background knowledge. Ito yung sa comprehension. Highlight and patterns. Mas na-highlight natin yung patterns nila. Critical features. Nakakapagbigay tayo ng big ideas and relationships. We will guide the information's processing and visualization na ma-maximize natin yung transfer and generalizations. And dito naman sa how, ito yung how ng internalize. Provides option for executive functions. Ano nga ba to? What are those? Guide appropriate goal setting. Mas nag-guide natin sila sa appropriate yung goal nila. Support planning and strategy development. Mas nakakapag-support tayo ng mga plano nila at mga strategy para mas ma-develop, makapag-develop pa sila. At facilitate managing information and resources. Enhance capacity for monitoring progress. And also, dito naman tayo sa goal. Sa goal. Sa goal naman tayo, purposely and motivated. Mas namamotivate natin sila. And resourceful and knowledgeable. Mas nakakapagbigay tayo ng resourceful at nakapagbigay tayo ng mga knowledge sa kanila. Strategic and goal-directed. Through this approach, ito yung mga approach, diba? So, through this approach, students will be given alternates in the class requirements for the rate, timing, and the use of motor movements. They could also give different options in the presenting their outputs, such as using multiple media. Ito yung mga nabibigay nating multiple media text, speech, drawing, storyboards, films, physical manipulates, blogs, and social media, and other interactive tools, and web applications. Additionally, they could also be given individual choice and autonomy in pursuing the class outputs and activities. This way, learners improve their self-sufficiency and independence while having the options of collaborate with others. So, dito pala sa chapter 17 na to, ito na yung inclusion ng mga learning with disabilities saka without disabilities. Mas nabubus nila yung confidence nila kapag mas lalo silang nakikisalamuha sa mga without disabilities. At mas, kumbaga, nagkakaroon tayo ng equality or pantay-pantay na pakikis pa equality, pantay-pantay na pagbibigay servisyo sa mga with disabilities. At yung pinakamaganda dito dun sa mga without disabilities, mas na hindi nababawasan yung fairness nila at mas nakakapagbig, mas na-enhance yung respect nila sa social paikisalamuhan nila sa mga without disability. Diba? Kumbaga, mas nagiging ano sila, approachable sila doon. Ayun po. Thank you po sa pakikinig. I hope marami po kayong natutunan. And God bless po.